Praise the Lord. I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's all stand and ask God to have his way in this service this morning. Amen. Let's just get in this morning. Let's have church. Blessed Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come to you once again, God, we want to thank you, Lord. God, that you've allowed us all to be back in your house this morning, God, to come in to give you worship. God, to come in to give you praise this morning. Lord God, we just ask, God, that you would move in this place this morning. God, you have your way, not our will, but thy will be done in this place. Heavenly Father, let them all get in this morning. God, and we'll have church. Lord God, we just ask right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, you pour your spirit out upon this place. Heavenly Father, anoint the singing this morning. Anoint each and every one, God, that sings a special song today. Heavenly Father, God, we just ask, God, that you would move, Lord, upon our live stream audience this morning. God, that you would bless them this morning. Lord God, you would reach down and touch them right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Those that's sick and shut in and ain't able to be in the house of the Lord this morning, I pray, Heavenly Father, God, you touch them, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord God, we just thank you, God, for this day that you have made, that we can rejoice and be glad in it. And Lord God, we just ask, God, that you would open the ears for us today. God, that we can hear what the Spirit was saying to the church today. And Lord God, we thank you, God, for waking us all up, allowing us all to live one more day. Heavenly Father, God, and I give you praise, glory, and honor. God, we pray for all the other churches that's having service today. Lord God, we pray, God, that you be with them, bless them this morning. God, we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we give you all praise and all glory in the church. Say amen. Those wants to help Sister Nora come on up.
Page 25, He Abides. I'm rejoicing on the day as I walk on the road. Oh,
Didn't even bark. That was a shocker. The dog didn't bark. I got up and I looked to make sure Nora didn't fall going to the bathroom. That's the first thing I thought. She fell going to the bathroom. And I laid there and I tried to go back to sleep. It seemed like, oh, boy, I gotta go to sleep. But I guess I got enough rest yesterday. I slept till, what, Lord? I got up and I thought, well, I'm gonna watch Christmas break. And I rode over and I went off to sleep and didn't wake up till after 11 o'clock, I think it was, at night. And, tell you what, I just wore out. I don't know why, but I just wore out. But I'll tell you what, I appreciate the Lord today. Amen. I came here to praise God. I came here to give Him glory today. Amen. He gave me a word this morning. Amen. And I hope and pray that we take it to heart. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody got a prayer request this morning.
Remember the church, the direction of His church will always follow the leading of the Lord. Remember me.
Yes, amen. Like for you, remember Brother Brian Neal? Amen. They're not having church today because of sickness. There's a bunch of them sick in their church. So remember them, that God will touch their bodies. Amen. Somebody else this morning. Yes, amen. Somebody else.
Remember me and Joshua, always believing in the Lord. Remember me as I go for a second thing in
my life. Yes, somebody else.
Remember me and Daniel in our home.
Mama.
And pray for me, my chest is hurting this morning. I don't know why.
Yes, amen. Somebody else. Yes, amen. Somebody else? Yes. Remember Sister Julie today? She's not here, amen. I thought she might be here this morning, but remember her, amen. She's still battling some sickness, amen. And, also remember Rusty and Nora, the newlyweds. Amen. They're on their way to the Smokies. So let's pray that they have safe travel and mercy there and back. Amen. Also remember him because he is really needing our prayers. Amen. He told me the other day that he had some infection in his body. Amen. And he needed the Lord to touch him. So let's remember that. Also remember Nora's baby brother. I talked to him the other day. Amen. At the wedding. And I invited him to come be in church with us. Amen. So I hope and pray that he comes. Amen. I want to see him back on fire for God. I want to see him serving God, Junior. He can play these drums. I'm telling you, he's a good drummer. Amen. If we just get him in church and get him saved, amen, he'll be a good drummer for us. So y'all pray for him. Pray for Brother Larry Smallin's son. Amen. He needs our prayers. Amen. Somebody else this morning. Yes, amen. Somebody else.
Remember Carrie and Jeff, and remember Sister Faye, because she had an appointment today.
Yes, also remember Ronnie Sossman Tuesday. He's got to go have some surgery Tuesday. So remember him. I think he's blowed his other shoulder out. Amen. They're going to do surgery on him Tuesday, so remember him in prayer. Somebody else this morning. Yes, amen. Somebody else? Anybody on live stream, Joe?
No. No.
Yes, amen. Remember that. Also remember the lady down in Burkesville, Mississippi, amen. I ain't got to hear from her lately, but I don't know how she's doing. I hope. Pray she's doing better, amen. The lady out in Arizona that wants to see her grandkids saved, remember them. Remember Brandon down in Alabama, amen, that God would make a way where they'll follow the will of God, amen. They're wanting the will of God be done in their lives, so pray that God God will lead them the right way, amen. Show them where they need to be and what they need to do, amen. Pray for the people up in South Carolina, amen, that's been watching our live stream. And Brother Tony, amen, remember him. Amen. Anybody else before we pray?
Remember Christina, she has to have surgery.
Yes.
Remember Brother Randall Weaver.
Yeah, remember Brother Randall Weaver. He's got kidney stones, amen. Remember the Dean family? Amen. They seem like they're doing a little better, amen. I watched one of their live stream videos last night. It seemed like they're doing better. They're having fun with that new game now. Everybody bend over to touch the wall and try to pull up a chair. They're having fun, so they must be feeling better. So thank God for that. Anybody else before we pray? Yes, amen.
Remember them that the good Lord provided them to be able to get the bus.
Amen. She said, remember her, Mama.
No, she said, Papa.
Yeah. Well, maybe remember her. You got to have surgery, ain't that right, baby? Yeah, amen.
Remember
what?
That we use wisdom in all the things that we say. We live around the world, try to work with somebody, or we just kind of talk to them.
Amen. Remember, I talked to Rudy last night, and I was talking to him, amen, and he called me, I think it was day before yesterday, and he asked me about that little boy that sang that song, that Owens boy, Owens Mac, or whatever his name is, the one that sings that, if Jesus come to your house, amen, and he listened to that song, and tears began to roll down his face. I said, that touch home, don't it? He said, yeah, because what if he did come to my house and I'm not, I said, you need to get ready. Amen. So remember him. If it just takes that song, amen, to get into hold of him. Amen. That's one step. Amen. So remember that. Remember the service today. Remember me. Amen. I need your prayers. Amen. Remember those that sang us today. And let's just get in and have church. Amen. And unspoken quest by the raising of your hands. Amen. You pray at your seat or pray at the altar.
Thank you.
Amen. Ask Sister Connie to pray over all. If you got your tithes, amen, just put it in there or put it up here in the box. It don't matter, amen. God knows where it's going.
that, well, let's stand up and worship the Lord this morning. I don't know about anybody else, but I came to serve God, so.
Amen.
Come on, look at that, get something.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. I fall number one, would surely be me. I fall priest. Ain't gonna be long, we're gonna see that old Cain not be there, amen.
That's right, amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, if you got your Bibles, turn with me to the Old Testament. Deuteronomy chapter 32. I'm going to skip around reading, amen, but this is what the Lord laid on my heart. I got some other scriptures to go to, but Deuteronomy chapter 32. If you got it, stand for the reading of the Word. Praise the Lord. Beginning at verse number 1, it says, "Give ear, O ye heavens, and I will speak, and hear, O earth, the words of my mouth. My doctrine shall drop as the rain. My speech shall distill as the dew, as the small rain upon the tender herbs, and as the showers upon the grass, because I will publish the name of the Lord. Ascribe ye greatness unto our God." Verse number 4 says, "He is the rock. His work is perfect, for all his ways are judgment, a God of truth, and without iniquity. Just and right is he. They have corrupted themselves. Their spots is not the spots of his children. They are perverse and crooked generation." And verse number 18 says, so it goes to verse number 16. It says, "They provoked him to jealousy with strange gods, with abomination, provoking they him to anger. They sacrificed unto devils, not to God, to the gods, who they knew not, to new gods that came newly up, whom your fathers feared not. Of the rock that beget thee, thou art unmindful, having forgotten God that formed thee." Now go over here to verse number 30. He says, "Now show one, how should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight, except their rock have sold them, and the Lord has shut them up. For their rock is not our rock, as our rock. Even our enemies themselves being judges. For their vine is of the vine of Solomon, and their fields of Gomorrah. Their grapes are the grapes of gall. Their clusters are bitter. Their wine is poison of dragons, and the cruel venom of asps." Verse number 36. "For the Lord shall judge his people, and repenteth himself for his servant, when he seeth that that their power is gone, and there is none shut up or left. And ye shall say, where are their gods? The rock in whom they trust." Verse number 39 says, "See now that I am he, that there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hands. For I lift up my hands unto the heavens and say, I live forever." Blessed Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come to you once again. Lord, I want to thank you, Lord God, for having another opportunity, God, to be able to stand. Lord God, to bring this bread of life forth this morning. And I pray, Heavenly Father, God, that you use me this morning. God, like you showed me this morning, God. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you take a coal off the altar and purge my lips. That I'll say what thus saith the word of the Lord. I pray, God, you get me out of the way and let the Holy Ghost come in. Let the Holy Ghost be the preacher. Let it be the teacher this morning. Heavenly Father, God, I ask, God, that you would move, God, upon this congregation this morning. I pray, God, that you anoint them. Lord, open their ears that they can hear what the Spirit was saying to the church this morning. And Heavenly Father, I pray you get me out of the way and let the Holy Ghost come in. And let the Holy Ghost be the teacher. And let it be the guider this morning. And Lord God, we fail to give you all the praise and all the glory and the honor this morning. You're worthy to be praised this morning, God. And we thank you, God, for this word this morning, God. We just praise you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. The church say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says here in verse number 4, he is the rock. His work is perfect. For all his ways are just judgment. A God of truth and without iniquity, just and right is he. Amen. They have corrupted themselves. Their spots is not of the spots of his children. They are perverse and a crooked generation. Amen. I want to preach just a little while. God, help me. Amen. On the rock. Amen. The rock. Amen. As I was studying this and I was reading about the rock. Amen. And I began to run some reference. Amen. And you know where the rock first started? Amen. Amen. The rock started the day that God told Moses. Amen. He told him, he said, you go down to the brook. Amen. And there's a rock down there. Amen. And all I want you to do is stretch your rod over that rock. Amen. And when you stretch that rod over that rock, water will come out and they'll be able to drink. Amen. And I began to study it. Amen. And Moses, glory to God, he got angry because the children were murmuring and complaining. Amen. They were fussing and bickering and fighting. Amen. They were complaining because they didn't have nothing to eat. They was complaining because they didn't have nothing to drink. Amen. And God told him, he told him, he said, you go down there and stretch your rod out across it. Amen. And that rod would come forth. But Moses got angry and he smoted that rock. Amen. But water came out of that rock anyway. Amen. And I began to read the word. Amen. And I remember the Bible said they come past the mountain. Amen. They made laps around the mountain. Glory to God. 40 years. Amen. They come past that mountain. Amen. Because Moses got angry. Amen. And God put his wrath upon them. Amen. He said, you'll come past this mountain. Amen. And they come past it long enough, finally. Amen. Till they realized, amen. Amen. That God was the provider. He was the one that fed them.
Amen.
Amen. He's the one that gave them the water. He's the one that rained the manna down from heaven. Amen. As I began to read this in Deuteronomy, amen, and I thought, he said, he is the rock. His work is perfect. Who was he talking about there? He was talking about Jesus Christ being the rock. Amen. He said he is the cornerstone, the chief cornerstone. Amen. The builders reject him. Amen. People reject Jesus every day. I said, and I listened to that woman the other day say, I pray for the president. I pray for him. I pray for him. I don't hate him. Amen. But I'll kill them little babies. Amen. I'll do this. I don't want the Bible in the churches. I don't want the Bibles in people's homes. We're going to get rid of them. But she's going to pray for the president. Amen. She's going to pray for the president. She don't know who the rock is. Amen. They still go to the priest. Amen. And they say, well, we killed this many babies. We'll go to the priest this morning and we'll go in there and do so many Hail Marys. Amen. And we'll do our little sing-sing. Amen. And we'll go in that little booth and we'll say faithful. Amen. Sister Connie sung that song. Amen. She didn't know I was going to preach about the rock. Amen. I thought about how, amen, sometimes I get dry. Amen. And I get thirsty. And Junior, I have to go to the rock. Amen. I got to go back to Jesus. And I say, I want another drink of that living water. I need another drink. Amen. I need another drink of that water, that fresh water. Amen. That water that came out of that rock, it wasn't muddy. Amen. It wasn't stale. He gave him the best water there was. Amen. They got to drink the best water. Amen. Well, why? Because Jesus Christ won't give you nothing. Amen. It ain't good for you. Amen. He'll give you water to take you through the church. Amen. He'll give you water to make you go on through the day. Amen. I thought about it. Amen. He said, they have corrupted. They have corrupted themselves. Their spots is not the spots of his children. And they are pervert and perverse and a crooked generation. This nation that we live in today is a perverse and a crooked generation. They're not his people. He's got his people. And his people knows who he is. But this world has got itself in a corrupt generation. It is corrupting itself every day. It's corrupting itself as we're speaking right now. Amen. Somebody right now is being killed. Amen. Somebody right now is being raped. Somebody right now is being molested. A corrupt generation. Amen. Until the church world gets founded upon the true rock. Amen. And they get their life upon the rock, which is Jesus Christ. Amen. They're not going to be able. Amen. The church is not going to go forth. Amen. If they don't get founded upon the rock. Amen. Hallelujah. Verse 18 says, of the rock that beget thee, thou art unmindful, and have forgotten God that formed thee. See, there's people that serves a rock, but it ain't Jesus. Amen. I read in there where he said, amen, that they serve rocks, amen, the gods of stone. Amen. They serve the gods of wood. Amen. They serve the gods, amen, that were man-made. Amen. The other gods. He said the other gods. Amen. Instead of the true God, they're serving the other gods. What is the church world doing today? They're serving their new gods. Amen. He said they've got new gods. Amen. They're serving these new gods. Amen. They found out, hey, we don't have to serve the true God. All we got to do is make us a new God. Amen. He'll let us preach what we want to. Yeah, that new God will let you preach whatever you want. But that God that I serve won't let me preach whatever I want. Amen. He told me this morning. He said, I'll pound you up on a rock. He said, upon this rock I'll build my church. And the gates of hell shall not. He said, shall not prevail against it. I said, yes, Lord. Boy, I thought I was going to preach on the mountain, being up on the mountaintop this morning. Man, it come to me when I was in the shower. The mountaintop. Give me that mountain one more time, Lord. Just show me how to climb it. Lord, just give me that mountain. I thought, well, that's what it's going to be. Amen. And I got to get ready to get out of the shower. And all of a sudden, he said, the rock. I said, the rock. I said, I know Jesus is that rock. Amen. I know he's my rock. I know he said, amen, that he was the rock of my salvation. Amen. He is my fortress. Amen. He will protect me. Amen. But he said, I want you to go to Deuteronomy. Amen. And I looked it up. Amen. And I went right there to it. Amen. And it tells you, amen, that he was that rock in the beginning. He's going to be the rock in the end. Amen. He's not that Rocky Balboa. Amen. He's not the rock. Amen. That thinks he's the big old mighty man. But Jesus is the rock. Amen. He is your rock today. Amen. Who are you founded upon, church? Are you really founded upon the true rock? Amen. Have you got your feet grounded and rooted upon the rock? Amen. He said, upon this rock, I will build my church.
Amen.
And the gates of hell will not prevail against it. He told Peter there. He said, upon this rock. Who was he talking about? He was talking about himself. He said, I'm going to build this church. And you know why he said the gates of hell would not come against it? Because when he died on that cross, he went down into hell. Amen. And he opened them gates and he went in. Amen. And he said, bring them keys to me, boy. I come to take them back. He knew that they were gates down there. Because he'd done been down there. And he told him, I don't care how much comes against the church. I don't care, Peter. Upon this rock, I'll build my church. Amen. There ain't nobody going to be able to come against it.
That's right.
They'll try. They'll try to prevail against it. Amen. They'll try to tear it down. Amen. They'll talk about it. Amen. They'll talk about the members in the church. Amen. They'll put them down. Amen. He said in verse 30, now shall one cease, chase 1,000, and put 10,000 to flight, except their rock have sold them, and the Lord has shut them up. For their rock is not as our rock. The world's rock, this is what I got this morning. Did you know the Lord know that the world was going to have them a rock? You say, brother, there's a way you're going to get at it. I'm going to tell you. It's called rock and roll. Rock and roll. AC/DC. They pray to the gods. Black Sabbath, they pray to the gods. Kiss, pray to the gods. And now the church world is praying to the new gods. Because they're bringing the rock and roll temporary gospel music into the house of God. They're bringing their flashing lights. They're bringing their strobe lights. They're bringing their new gods into the sanctuary. I said, okay, Lord. He said, they're serving their new. See, God knew all that was going to take place. You said, well, Brother Miller, there's nothing wrong with rock and roll music. There's nothing wrong with listening to AC/DC. There's nothing wrong with listening to Black Sabbath. There's nothing wrong listening to the Doors. There's nothing wrong listening to all this. Perversion. Corrupt generation. And the devil listened to what he wanted to hear. All these kids. Rock and roll. I get them to rock and I get them to roll. I'll get into their minds and I'll get into their soul. And I'll cause them to do things that they would not do. Jesus is the rock. And he said, I will get into your soul. I will get into your heart. And I'll cause you to do things that you never would have thought you would ever do. I'll cause you to raise your hands and praise God. I'll cause you to dance in the spirit. I'll cause you to speak in tongues. Amen. He said, I'll give you something that you can do. But the devil said, I've got to have something that I can get this world to be perverted and be corrupt. Amen. And there is another rock. Amen. He was telling us there is a true rock, and then there's a rock in this world. Amen. And that devil is a rock in this world. Amen. He thought he could do what Jesus has done. He still thinks he can be like Jesus, but he cannot be. Amen. Because Jesus told Peter, he said, upon this rock, in other words, upon me, I'm going to build a church in the gates of hell. The devil cannot come against me. Amen. This world, amen, can howl, they can part. Amen. But Jesus said they cannot prevail against me. But they listen to this rock and roll music, and them demon spirits gets on them kids and causes them to do crazy stuff. Amen. It'll cause them, Sister Bonnie, to take their clothes off and throw them up on the stage. It'll cause them to throw themselves down on the ground and just flop like dead fish. It'll cause them to get up on the stage and jump off, hoping that somebody will catch them and carry them through the crowd. Amen. It'll get into their minds. It gets into their hearts. Amen. It begins to eat at them. Amen. And it begins to tell them, did you know AC/DC? Amen. They pray every day before they go to a concert. They kneel down before this idol and they pray to it. And they call up the spirits to go out and get into the people. Amen. To cause them to hallucinate, cause them to drink and drink and drink and take them drugs. Amen. Get a hold of them, Satan. Cause them to be corrupt. You cause them to go to hell. Amen. That's what he wants. Amen. He wants you to listen to that corrupt stuff. Amen. He wants you to be lost. He don't want you to be founded upon this true rock. He wants the church world to get into these new gods. He said, I found out. The parents ain't going to let them listen to that stuff, so I'll put it into the gospel music. I'll put the same beat in there. I'll put the same lyrics in there. We'll just add Jesus to it every once in a while. We'll add something about God in it every once in a while. And we'll get them swayed over. Because the parents will let them bring that into their house. You say, Brother Miller, is that what's going on? Yes, that's what's going on. Amen. They've not only just brought it into their house. Now the choir leaders, amen, the praise team leaders, amen, wants to bring it into the house of God. And Jesus said, upon this rock, amen, upon this house, amen, the gates of hell can't come against it. Upon God's true church. But see, the world wants all this stuff. Because, see, they done it while he was out in the world. But my Bible tells me, as I read my word this morning, it said the old man died out, and a new man came in me. Who was that new man? It was the rock. It was Jesus Christ. He came into my heart. He cleansed me. He washed me whiter than snow. Amen. He said the old man dies out. Behold, a new man comes in. The old man of sin died out. That old man of sin no longer lives there. And I also thought that I was going to preach on this morning. I was up there at Dora's cousin's last night and we were talking. Amen. And he had some chocolate milk that was organic. I said, well, they had to find an organic chocolate cow out there somewhere. Brother Wayne. And the Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, there are a lot of organic Christians. A lot of the organic, a lot of the fat-free, a lot of the light Christians, a lot of those that don't want the full vitamin D version. amen, they just don't want that full version of the Bible, amen. They just want part of it. They don't want that kind of being sprayed with the Holy Ghost and fire. Amen, they want to pick and choose what they want to eat out of that word. Amen, they don't want to really be founded upon the rock. Amen, they don't want to be founded upon Jesus Christ. Amen, he said here in verse number 31, he says, for the rock is not as our rock, even our enemies themselves being judged. Judges. Oh, have we got a lot of them? Have we got a lot of them? I was reading that and I said, Lord, what's that mean? He said, your enemies are judging you. The enemies is coming against you. They're judging you because you're preaching the truth. Amen. You're getting under their toes. You're getting under their playground. Amen. You're mixing up their little playground that they're playing with. Amen. He said, they're going to get mad at you. Amen, because you're mixing up their game. Amen, I watched the basketball game, and I watched how Cal Perry the other day, he mixed up the team, amen, and he got that team confused. Amen, and Kentucky began to win, amen, they began to go and do more. Amen, that's the way God is, amen, he confuses us. Sometimes he'll change us around, sometimes we'll see if we'll be willing to follow him, amen, and do what he says to do. Amen. I watched, you watch hockey games every once in a while. Amen. And they'll switch themselves up. Amen. They'll switch off. And them other hockey players will be watching, seeing what's going on. Amen. And they switch the game up. Amen. The devil has switched the game up on the church world. Amen. He has really switched the game up. Amen. He's got the enemies judging you. Amen. Well, you're judging me. No, when you tell them the truth, they don't like it. Amen. When you tell them about their sins, they don't like it. When you get onto their sins, amen, they get mad at you. Amen. They'll say, well, we ain't coming back there. We ain't going there. Amen. Because he don't like the way we do. He don't like the way we gossip. He don't like the way we go out here and talk about each other. Amen. The Bible says it's wrong. Amen. If the Bible says it's wrong, it's wrong. Now, if you're rightly judging somebody, and you see them doing something they ain't supposed to be doing, you need to go to them and say, hey, let me tell you something. In love, put your arm around me. And say, brother, and you don't need to be doing that. Jesus loves you and he wants you not to be doing that. You need to quit doing what you're doing, amen. And say, Lord, I'm sorry. But instead of that, amen, they'll go and they'll go do it in anger. Amen, and they'll do it in hatefulness. Amen, and they won't speak to you. When they see you, they'll walk right by you. Amen, and they won't say nothing to you. And God told me last night, he said, they're going to judge you. They're going to judge you. Amen, they're going to judge me because what I'm preaching this morning. Amen, because some of these churches out there, amen, all they want to do is see how many they can get into their church. Amen, amen, they want to see how many they can fill up. Amen. And they're not worried about preaching about the rock. They're not worried about preaching about salvation. They're not worried about telling them about sin. Because they know sin will cause people to leave the house of God. When you begin to call people's sins out, amen, that's when you see them going out of the church. They don't want to get founded upon that true rock. Amen. He said, for their vine is as the vines of Sodom and of the fields of Gomorrah. Their grapes are the grapes of gall. Their clusters are bitter. Amen. This world is what he was talking about. This world has got like Sodom and Gomorrah. Amen. Drag queens teaching you kids in school. Lesbians, homosexuals teaching your kids in school. Lesbians, I just saw on Hallmark Channel where Hallmark's going to go transgender, going to start going homosexuality. That just hurt a lot of Christian people right there because that's their channel. Disney, Frozen. what's her name? Elsa's going to have her a lesbian lover in Frozen 3. A perverse generation. They got their own rock that they're founded on. Amen. They want to try to say something about God, and they don't even know what He is. Amen. They just want to speak it because they hear everybody else saying something about it. Amen. That's why they're saying, well, we believe in God. I heard Joe Biden today, well, I thank God that He is going to bless America. When I become president, He's going to bless America. He's going to make America back what America is. Here you the one said you like little kids jumping on your lap. Here you the one let the little kids play with your hairs on your legs while you're in a swimming pool. And you think you're going to get God back in America? Perverse generation. A crooked, crooked generation. Amen. They won't found upon that rock. He said they was like Sodom and Gomorrah. Their grapes are like the grapes of gall. Their clusters are bitter. Oh, I like this part. Their wine is the poison of dragons. And the cruel venom of apes. I listened after the ball game went off. I don't know if anybody else listened to it. But the bourbon place in Kentucky, up there in Bardstown, up there, I don't forget what that county is up there, Lure County. Anyway, they were on there and they were talking about the state of Kentucky. And did you know that the bourbon factory had been there for years? And they made Kentucky bourbon for years. The bootleggers would run bootleg out want this one tavern there. They had a store there. And they would run the bootleggers would run whiskey out the back door as much as they people come in the front door. Amen. And they'd run that boot, they had moonshine. They come in to bust them. The feds come in to bust them. Come in there to raid them. And they had over 450 gallon, big glass gallon jugs down in a well of moonshine. They came in and took all the whiskey out and they poured all of it out down in the river. They broke the bottles and poured it out in the rivers. And somebody made a joke about it and said, I wonder how many fish got drunk that day. But the good stuff, they said, was still in the well. They had hid it down in the well. That place is still open today. That guy, that his grandpa opened that place and bootlegged out of it. Then his daddy took over it. Now he's over it. And they're bragging about it. And did you know what the bourbon factory said? They said, for it's over, every state in Kentucky, every county will be wet in Kentucky. They made a promise when they opened that brewery that every county in Kentucky will be wet. And they showed a map of the ones that started going wet. And the ones that they didn't think, that people didn't think that was going wet, went wet. And you know what they said that caused it to do that, Brother Wayne? Was the young generation that's coming up today. It was not the older ones that voted it in. It was the young, pervert generation of today. The crooked generation. They said the young people voted Midtown County in. Three young people voted to get the alcohol into Midtown County. They brought it up. Then they brought it to Bering County. And they took it to Warren County. Warren County was for Bering County. There's just a little bit more, and for long, Kentucky bourbon will have the whole state of Kentucky under alcohol. They said they'll have more bars set.
it. Amen. It's a pervert generation. It's a crooked generation. We need to get pounded up on the rock, church. You say, well, Brother Miller, I watched it yesterday. Yeah, they said, well, it's next. They said every county in the state of Kentucky will be under Kentucky Bourbon. They will be under them. And I thought, Brother Wayne, how they're going boom, 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 just like that. How many young people have you seen dead? Just the other day, a boy hit a woman head on in a car, head on. Killed her instantly. Drunk, under the influence of alcohol. He survived, but she didn't. 9 times out of 10, the alcoholic survives and the other one don't. The innocent person gets killed. Glasgow Police Department sits right down here. Amen, on Columbia Avenue, and watches them leave that tavern down there. And when they leave, they pull them over and write them a ticket for DUI. Amen, they take their car and impound it. Amen, they're making money. Amen, that's what it's all about. It's a crooked generation. Amen, we're in a pervert generation. Amen, we got people nowadays. Amen, they would rather shoot you than to look at you. Because they're not founded upon the rock. Amen. Psalms 18 and 2. Psalms 18 and 2. Says, the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler, and my horn of my salvation, and my high tower. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. The Lord is my rock and my fortress. And my deliverer. Amen. Ain't you glad he can deliver you from things that this world tries to put upon you? Ain't you glad that he can deliver you, amen, from alcohol? Ain't you glad he can deliver you from drugs? Ain't you glad he can deliver you from sex? Amen. I was telling y'all the other day about Nora's cousin helping somebody the other day. Amen. Because his little baby was supposed to be in the hospital in Louisville, had an allergic reaction to some medication. Amen. And he's in Barron County Jail for raping a young girl. Amen. Underage. Amen. He's in jail right now. Amen. A pervert generation. Amen. Ungodly generation. But I know a God that can deliver him. Amen. I know the rock. Amen. That can deliver him. Amen. I'm so glad one day that I found that rock. He is my salvation. He is my strength. Amen. In the time of trouble. He is my anchor in my midst. Storm. Amen. He is my rock. Amen. That I can hold on to. Amen. When I need help. Church, when you need help, you need to call out upon the rock. Amen. He will be right there. And I ain't talking about the tooth fairy rock. All these parents, these Christian parents that tells their children that the tooth fairy's going to give them $1, liars. Ain't no such thing as a tooth fairy. They tell them the Easter bunny's going to bring them candy. Liars. Ain't no Easter bunny. They tell them Santa Claus is going to fly in a sleigh with reindeers. Amen. And he's going to bring them gifts. He ain't finding no reindeers. Amen. He's not riding in a sleigh. Amen. But I told my kids when they were growing up, whoever brought you a gift was Santa Claus. Amen. It don't matter. Amen. Santa Claus first started out as Saint Nick. He was a child of God. Amen. He was a Christian. And he took gifts and gave them to kids. And this whole pervert generation, amen, this crooked generation has took everything. thing that God meant for good and they turn it around to make evil out of it. Just like Halloween. It wasn't made for what it is today. Thanksgiving was made to give thanks unto God. It wasn't to talk about politics. It wasn't about watching football games. Amen. It was giving thanks for the year that God had blessed you with. And give Him thanks for allowing you to be able to eat that food that's on your table. That's what it was about. Christmas is about Jesus Christ, the rock. Amen. That was born in a manger. Amen. He came down upon this earth. Amen. As a little baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. Amen. That's what you need to start telling your children. Tell them about the rock. Tell them about Jesus Christ. Baby in the manger. Mary, did you know one day that your baby, boy, was going to be the healer of all nations? Mary, did you know that your baby was going to be the rock, the solid rock? But this world has changed everything around. Happy holiday. Happy holiday. Donald Trump says, Merry Christmas, world. We put Christ back into Christmas. Merry Christmas. How many of y'all seen all these manger scenes going up all around the world? Amen. They're putting them up everywhere. Amen. They're telling, yeah, go ahead, say something. We're going to place them out there. We got a right to. Amen. We got a right to put Merry Christmas. I listened to that woman on TV on the parade thing Nora had on her phone. Amen. They were hollering, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Amen. They were happy to be able to say Merry Christmas. Year before last, all they could say was Happy Holiday. Happy Holiday. Amen. They know who the rock is. Amen. They know where it's founded upon. Amen. Church, we got to get founded upon the rock. Psalms 144, verse 1. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It says, blessed be the Lord, my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight. My goodness and my fortress, my high tower, and my deliverer, my shield, and he in whom I trust, whom subdue my people under me. Amen. He said, my goodness. Ain't you glad he's your goodness? Ain't you glad he's your fortress, your high tower? Amen. Your deliverer, your shield. Amen. Ain't you glad you got a rock? Amen. It's like that. Ain't you glad you got somebody, amen, that's like that? 2 Samuel chapter 22 and verse number 32. Amen. Hallelujah. These are the verses that God gave me. I didn't even get to highlight them. 22 and verse 32. He said this. He said, for who is God save the Lord, and who is a rock save our God? God is my strength and my power, and he maketh my way perfect. He maketh my feet like hinds' feet. And he sets me upon a high place. He teaches my hands to war, so that the bow of the steel is broken. My mind arm. Thou hast also given me the shield of thy salvation. And the gentleness has made me great. Thou hast enlarged my steps under me, so that my feet did not slip. Amen. Ain't you glad of that rock? Matthew chapter 16 and verse number 18. And I say unto you, this is that. I say unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven.
Amen. In 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 2. I hope y'all enjoying this, church. I am.
Hallelujah. There is none holy as the Lord. For there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our God. Ain't no more rock like him.
That's right,
I'm going to tell you right now, you ain't going to find none like him.
Amen.
Amen. He said, there is none holy as the Lord. For there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our God. Amen.
Matthew 7 and 24. He said, well, Brother Miller, you're going all through the Bible. Well, this is what God laid on my heart.
He said, therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man, which built his house upon the rock. And the rains descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. Everyone that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not, then that shall be likened unto a foolish man, which built his house upon the sand. And the rains descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell, and the great was the fall of it. Amen. Luke chapter 8 and verse number 13. Says in verse number 13, says, they on the rock are they which when they hear and receive the word with joy, and these have no root, which for a while believeth, and in time of temptation falleth away. And that which fall among thorns are they which when they have heard, go forth and are choked with the cares and riches and pleasures of this life, bringing no fruit to perfection. But that on the good ground are they which in the host an honest and good heart, heaven having heard the words, keep it and bring it forth fruit with patience.
Amen. The Bible's telling us. Amen. Go to Revelations chapter 21 and verse 11. Amen. He was telling you right there, amen, that the wise man built his house upon the rock.
And church, what I've got to tell you today is God said to tell you to be like that wise man and put your house upon the rock. Amen. When the gates of hell comes against you, when the winds blow, when the storms of this life, amen, when the storms of sickness blows against you, he said, establish your going upon the rock. Build upon that rock, because the winds of this life cannot destroy you as long as you build upon that rock. Amen. Revelation 21. In verse number 11, it says this: having the glory of God, her light was likened unto a stone most precious, even like jasper stone, clear as crystal, and having a wall of great height, and a 12 gates, and at the gates 12 angels, and the name written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. On the east, 3 gates. On the north, 3 gates. On the south, 3 gates. On the west, 3 gates. And the wall of that city has 12 foundations, and in them the name of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. See, he said, upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell won't prevail against it. Did you know in heaven that there's a wall? Amen. And there's 12 foundations. 12 foundations. That's a lot of rock, ain't it? And those 12 foundations are the name of the apostles of the Lamb, which were Jesus' apostles. Amen. Their names are there. And the last one is 1 Corinthians 10 and 4. And did all drink, I want y'all to listen to this one. And did all drink the same spiritual drink, for the brink of the spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. Did you hear that? All from the beginning was about the rock, where Moses struck that rock and out came the water. Amen. And in the end here it says, and did all drink the same spiritual drink. For they drank of the spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. So church, what I'm trying to tell you today is we got to follow that rock. We got to drink of that spiritual drink that he pours out. Sometimes our wells gets dry. Sometimes our mouth gets cottony. Like we feel like we can't pray, and we feel like that there's no spiritual stuff there. But all we got to do is make ourselves to that rock and begin to cry out and say, Lord Jesus Christ, thou art this rock. Thou art my rock. Give me something to drink, and he'll give you that spiritual drink. Amen. And you can drink of that spiritual drink and you'll never thirst again. Amen. If you just get a hold of what I'm trying to tell you this morning. Church, there is a drink that we can drink of. Amen. This water right here just cools my thirst for a little bit. Amen. But when I get into the spiritual realm of God, and I begin to pray and I begin to talk to that rock, amen, my water begins to pour. Amen. A well begins to spring up inside of me. Amen. He said it's like a river flowing. Amen. It's joy. Amen. Unspeakable. And full of glory. Amen. I'm so glad that I know who the rock is. And his name is Christ. Amen. Church, don't build yourself upon these other gods. Don't build yourself upon these new gods. Don't build yourself upon these old rocks. Amen. That'll cause you to fall. People is building themselves upon rocks because they want to build themselves. Amen. I let Jesus build me. He's alive, community church. Let Jesus build this church. Amen. We didn't build it. He did. And when we get that, we think that we've done it, then we're in the wrong. I built this church. I have built this church. He said, and the gates of hell will not come against it. They might howl and they might holler. They might try to prevail. But he said, I was just standing up here a while ago. And I felt something walk behind me. And I felt it touch me. I felt it get a hold of my shoulder. Put his hand up on my right shoulder. And he said, I am the Christ. I am the rock. Amen. I am your rock. I am your salvation. There's no other. Amen. They might have these strange gods. They might have these new gods. Amen. But we're founded upon the true rock. Amen. We're founded upon the rock. Amen. That we know in the Word of God. Amen. We're founded from Genesis to Revelations. Amen. He was the rock in the beginning. He's going to be the rock in the end. Amen. And I'm founded upon Him. Amen. I stand upon this Word. Amen. I'll preach this Word to the day I die. Amen. I ain't gonna water it down. I ain't gonna sugarcoat it. Amen. Because He is the rock. Amen. He's not rock candy, but He is the rock of my salvation. Amen. You stand upon that rock. Stand upon the Word of God. Amen, church. I hope you got what I'm trying to tell you. There in 1 Corinthians, He said, I am that rock. I am the Christ. Amen. I am that rock. It was in the beginning. I'll give you that spiritual drink. I'll give you that water. Amen. If you hunger and thirst, I'll fill you. Amen. You want that Holy Ghost? And you want to be sanctified real good? Amen. You come to this altar and begin to seek God and get sanctified. Amen. And He said, I will fill you with the Holy Ghost. But you've got to be sanctified. Amen. You've got to be purified. Amen. You can't have no sin in your life. I heard somebody preaching the other day, Brother Wayne, and they said this. They said, you don't have to speak in tongues to have that spirit, because Jesus said He gave it to us. But I read all through the Bible. He said, you must believe first. You got to believe in Him first. He said, then be sanctified, and then be filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. They said, well, he said that He was going to come back and He was going to bolt inside of us. He didn't say He was coming back. He said, I'm going to send you a comforter. My Father in heaven's going to send Him to you. He didn't say I was going to come back down here and take a bolt in you and stay with you. He said, I'm sitting on the Father's right hand. I'm making intercession for Him. But He said, I'll save your soul. See, He said He would come in and He would sup with you when you believed in Him. He said, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. He said, if any man would open unto me, in other words, if you believe on me, as the Scripture says, amen, if you believe on me, as the Scripture says, upon this rock I'll build my church. Amen. Jesus will come inside of you. He'll make a bowl in you. And He'll stay. Till you get good and sanctified. And you get filled with that heaven's Holy Ghost. And then that Holy Ghost will be your teacher. And that Holy Ghost will be your guide. Amen. He'll lead you to all truth. Amen. He'll show you places. But He said, I am the rock, church. And I'll have no other rock before me. I heard somebody say we need all this new stuff to get people saved now. We need the flashing lights. We need the fog machines in the church to get people saved. Get them ready to go to heaven. front and you'll have them sit in these chairs. Brother Wayne, you'll shake your hand and say, you're saved, brother. You're saved, brother. You're saved, sister. Didn't even ask God to save them. Or they'll say, repeat this after me. But not once do they say, you've got to believe. The Bible said, many confess with this mouth. But this thing here, this heart is so far from him that they don't even accept him. Because somebody says, all you got to do is shake my hand. All you got to do is just say, follow after me. Repeat what I say. That's all good and well, but if you don't believe, it ain't going to do you no good. Amen. A man cannot save you, but Jesus Christ can. The rock. Church, who have you founded upon today? Who have you founded upon today? Are you founded upon these new rocks? These new gods? Are you founded upon the God? Are you founded upon the rock? Your fortress, your delivery, your high tower, your power, your goodness, your strength. Amen. Your shield, your buckler, your anchor. Who are you founded upon this morning? Stand all over the house. This altar's open. You need to come and pray. Bless you, Lord God, as I come before you this morning. I thank you, Lord God, for the word that you laid upon my heart this morning. God, that you let me know who the rock was. And Lord God, you let me know there in 1 Corinthians 4. Lord God, that he is the Christ, the rock of my salvation. He is my spiritual truth. Lord, he is the one that gives me that spiritual truth to drink from. Lord, help me, God, to be able to stand.
I want my love.
Amen. We want to tell our live stream audience, we appreciate you. Amen. For tuning us in this morning. Amen. We love you. Amen. We hope and pray that we've been a help to you some way this morning. Hope and pray that you realize that Jesus Christ is the rock. Amen. And you got to be founded upon the true rock. Amen. We appreciate you. We love you. We hope and pray you tune us back in tonight at 6 o'clock. And come listening, expecting God to do something for you. Amen. I believe God can go right straight through them live stream waves. Amen. And get a hold of you there in your bedroom, in your living room, wherever you may be, in your car, whatever you're watching us by. Amen. I believe God can get in there. Amen. And touch your life. Amen. We appreciate you. Until tonight at 6 o'clock, may God be with you is our prayer.